Hi everyone, it's Corrie here. Welcome to Sunday School at Home for this week. I'm so pleased you've been able to tune in and join us. And I hope you're doing well and that you're enjoying your last few weeks of school lessons before the summer. Well, later on in this video, we're going to find out more about what happened early in Jesus' ministry during his work here on earth. But before that, I wonder, which decision would you make? I'm going to show you two options to choose from, and you need to decide which one would you pick. And if you've got someone with you, maybe ask them. Find out, would they pick the same one? Okay, first one. If you had to choose between broccoli or chocolate, which one would you pick? What about a choice between football or tennis? And you don't get to say neither, you don't get to say both. You have to pick one. Football or tennis? Which one would you pick? Now, some of you will know that my answer to this one is very, very definite. If you could choose a pet, which one would it be? A cat or a dog? Would you rather have a maths test or a spelling test? You have to have a test. Which one would you rather have? Okay, bit of a strange one now. Which one of these paths would you choose to walk down? The overgrown one or the clear one? Where would you like to go for a walk? Why would you choose that one?
This just in. Jesus is in Capernaum and he has been doing miracles. Reports from eyewitnesses tell us he has healed lots of sick people. He's even freed people who had demons in them. Now, over to our reporter on the scene for a live update.
Hello from Capernaum, where lots of exciting things were happening. But now Jesus is nowhere to be found. Everyone is looking for him, but we don't know where he is. Sorry, I don't have any more news for you.
Well, that's a bit weird. Well, anyway, welcome back everyone. I wonder, what did you make of some of those decisions that I asked you about a few minutes ago? Were some of them easy? Were some of them harder? If you were with someone else, did you agree every single time? Or sometimes? Or not at all? Well, in today's true story from the Bible, we're going to find out about an important decision that Jesus had to make. And what he chose might be surprising to some of us. And to help us, our friend Tim has given us some of his famous drawings. Thank you, Tim. But before I read the Bible, let me pray. Father God, thank you for this time together. Thank you that we have the Bible available for us in our language. Thank you that we are free to read it whenever we want. And thank you that when we read the Bible, we can meet Jesus. Please help us to get to know him better this morning. Amen. Okay, so this is from the Bible, from Mark chapter 1, and we'll be looking at verses 27 to 39. And so when the story starts in verse 27, Jesus has been teaching the Jewish people in a synagogue, a Jewish meeting place, in a town called Capernaum. He's even healed a man there who had an evil spirit in him. and verses 27 and 28 say, "The people were amazed. They asked each other, 'What is happening here? This man is teaching something new, and he teaches with authority. He even gives commands to evil spirits, and they obey him.' And the news about Jesus spread quickly everywhere in the area of Galilee." So everyone in Capernaum and the surrounding area is talking about Jesus. What happens next? Jesus and his followers left the synagogue. They all went at once with James and John to the home of Simon and Andrew. Simon's mother-in-law was sick in bed with a fever. The people there told Jesus about her. So Jesus went to her bed, took her hand and helped her up. Immediately the fever left her and she was healed. Then she began serving them. Okay, Jesus has been doing some healings. That night, after the sun went down, the people brought to Jesus all who were sick. They also brought those who had demons in them. The whole town gathered at the door of the house. Jesus healed many who had different kinds of sickness. He also forced many demons to leave people. But he would not allow the demons to speak because they knew who he was. This is amazing. Jesus is doing so many miracles. He's healing all these sick people. He's getting rid of demons, freeing people, making them better. And everyone who sees this is amazed. So Jesus is becoming really, really popular. And people keep coming to see him. It's crowds of people. And the disciples must have thought, this is great. Everything's going brilliantly. Crowds of people are coming. Jesus is really popular. People are being healed left, right and centre. It sounds like the perfect start to Jesus' mission, doesn't it? There are loads of people following him. It's obvious what Jesus needs to do now. Is to keep going. More healings, more people, more crowds, more success. Let's find out. Early the next morning, Jesus woke and left the house while it was still dark. He went to a place to be alone and pray. Later, Simon and his friends went to look for Jesus. They found him and said, "Everyone is looking for you." This isn't what the disciples expected. This isn't what the crowds expected. Everyone's looking for Jesus. They want to follow him, but he went off on his own. Why? Jesus answered, "We should go somewhere else, to other towns around here. Then I can preach there too. That is the reason I came." So he travelled everywhere in Galilee. He preached in the synagogues and forced demons to leave people. So Jesus says that the reason he came was to preach. Do you remember last week's lesson? In Lynn's video, we learned that Jesus went into Galilee and preached the good news from God. So when Jesus says he came to preach, he's saying that he came to tell people the good news from God. But there were lots of crowds here, with lots of people who were sick or injured, with demons, people who really needed Jesus to heal them. So Jesus had a decision to make. He could stay in Capernaum and heal people, or he could go somewhere else and preach the good news. And Jesus decided that it was more important to preach than to heal. Do you think that's a strange decision? Think for a moment. What types of illnesses and injuries might these people have had? How many can you think of? about if someone had a broken arm? How could that have made their life harder? What do you think? There were ill and injured people who were coming to see Jesus. Why were they coming? Was Jesus the right person to come to? Thing is, Jesus could have done lots of very good things if he'd stayed in Capernaum and healed more people. And so that sounds like it would have been the right decision to make. But that wasn't what Jesus decided to do. He decided to go to other places and preach, to tell people the good news from God. Do you think that was because Jesus didn't care about those sick people? Or maybe he didn't like them very much? Is that why he left? No. That's not it at all. The Bible shows us again and again and again that Jesus is always loving. He even cares about people that other people don't like. So it's not that Jesus didn't care. But Jesus knew that telling people the good news was even more important than making sick people well. Why? Can you remember what that good news is? The good news? It's that God's King is here. Jesus, God's perfect promised King, is here. And so God's perfect kingdom is nearly here. And so everyone needs to turn back to God and come into the kingdom, because Jesus is here to rescue us. Good news. God's King, here to make us friends with God again. So here's a question for you to think about. And in a moment, you can pause this video and discuss it. Why is it more important for Jesus to preach the good news than to heal people? Pause now and have a think. What did you think? Maybe this will help you to understand it. Imagine someone was there and they'd broken their arm and it really hurt. I've broken a bone. It really hurts. And they couldn't wash and they couldn't dress themselves properly. What would they want Jesus to do for them? They'd probably want him to heal their arm, make it better. But if he just healed their arm, how long would that last? Would their arm be perfect forever? Would they be healthy forever? Would they live forever? Jesus could just heal their broken arm, but they would still get old, and they would still get sick, and they would still die one day. So their broken arm, even though it was painful and difficult and horrible, wasn't their biggest problem. They needed something even more than they needed their arm to be fixed. They needed to be friends with God and welcomed into God's kingdom. Because that would mean they would live forever in a perfect place, where there would be no more sickness and no more pain and no more broken bones. So Jesus knew that there was something even more important for him to do than to make sick people well. He needed to tell people the good news about God's King so that they could become friends with God again. So what about us here today? Because these last few months have been very strange, haven't they? And we've been worried, and we've been scared, and we've been lonely and we've been sad at times. And some people have got sick, and some people have died. And it has been hard for all of us in different ways. And it might be that recently or some other time in your life, you've been very sick yourself. It might be that you've known someone who has been sick or died. You might know what it's like to hurt because your body really hurts, or to hurt on the inside, to feel pain, to suffer. And that is horrible. And it is serious. And you might think, if God is in control of everything, and if he's good, and if he loves us, why doesn't he stop this from happening? And you know, that is a really big question. And I can't give you all of the answers in a video like this. I don't know all of the answers. But this bit of the Bible shows us something that can help us with these big questions. Because it shows us that sometimes what we think is the most important and best thing that God could do isn't the right thing. Because there were real sick and real injured people in Capernaum. There were people who were really feeling pain, people who had very difficult lives. And we understand why they thought that being healed would be the best thing that could happen for them, and the most important thing that Jesus could do. But Jesus knew that there was something even more important that the people needed. All of the people, not just those people in Capernaum, needed to hear the good news about God. And that's true today. Sometimes when things are really hard in our lives, or when big things like coronavirus happen that hurt lots of people, we think that the most important and best thing that God could do would be to stop it happening. And sometimes he does heal people and make things stop. But sometimes God knows that just stopping it is not the best thing to do. And we don't always understand why. But we can, and we do know, that God still loves us, and that he really, really does know exactly what is the best thing for us all of the time. And that means that when bad things happen, we don't need to think that it means that God isn't there or God doesn't care. It means that God knows more than we do. Now that is a really, really big subject to think about, and you might have lots more questions about it. So can I encourage you to talk to your mum or your dad, or a trusted Christian adult? Ask them to help you to understand. And the other thing that we should do is we should pray. We should ask God to help us to understand and to trust him, even when things are hard. So I'm going to do that right now. Father God, thank you for Jesus. Thank you that he is your promised king, that he always does the best thing, even when it isn't what we would expect. Please help us to trust you, especially when our lives are hard, or when we are hurting. Please help us to know that you always know what the right thing for us is, and that you love your people as our perfect Father. Thank you that that is true, and please help us to believe it. Amen. Now there are a couple of song links in the description underneath this video. Okay, the first one is for the song Jesus Strong and Kind. And that one helps us to remember that Jesus is always there and always looking after us. Even when we're scared or we're weak or we're hurting. And the second one is Clap Your Hands. And that one reminds us all about that good news that Jesus knew was so important. That good news that God's King came and lived and died for his people. And that's amazing. So right now or in just a minute, you can click on those links and sing along with those videos and do the actions if you can remember them. But I'm just going to explain the craft to you. And today's craft is a little bit different. There aren't any sheets for you to print out and use. What I would like you to do is make a news report from Galilee. So you could do it like I did at the beginning with a video reporter. Or you can make a newspaper article. Here's some that I did. One about Jesus' baptism and one about Jesus going off to preach. You could make a blog post. You could do it on a computer or you could do it by hand. Whichever way you'd like to do it, make a news report about Jesus. And make sure that you point out that Jesus went off to preach the good news, not just heal people. So whatever way you choose to do it, I hope you have fun. Why not send those to me and Lynn when you're done? Because we'd love to see them. But for now, it's been great being with you today. I'm going to say goodbye. Bye, everyone. Goodbye.